first thing I'm going to show you guys is the stick-on stick, right? And this is a pretty cool one, and this is literally the easiest trick in the book. With this one, you can do a couple different things. What we're talking about is doing this. Right? You can do a lot of different things with that, but the initial setup of that is that you want to understand that the more pressure you put on the stick, the more notes you're going to get out of it, okay? So the first one would be to just sort of set your stick on the head doing nothing and try to dribble it. So it's kind of a one-to-one ratio. So you get that going. Okay. Cool part about that is that if you hit about a third of the way up the stick, you'll find that it stays pretty true to its balance with that. Now, if you want to put a little bit more pressure on the stick, you can start to get a different amount of notes out of it. Okay, so if you press the stick into the head and then just gently loosen the pressure, you can hear it start to buzz a little bit and then get back on. And all I'm doing is going from a dead stroke, kind of like what Jeff just showed you, and loosening that pressure so we get a buzz or multiple notes out. So you can do some pretty cool things with that. You can do a roll. You can do threes. You can do flam accents. Flam taps. You can do chuchuttas. And then my personal favorite is flam drags. So, some kind of cool stuff you can roll with that. Now, another thing too, you can take that single note, right? So that would all be, again, varying your fulcrum just as you would to like play a buzz roll or play an open roll or whatever. Same thing you can do with the single notes, and you can start to move that around a little bit, right? So I'm gonna try to move it through my fingers, up and down, and rest it on the rim. And the cool thing about this is that that fulcrum or that balance point just has to stay the same. Okay, so the trick changes, and there's a little bit of, you know, physical logistics on keeping the stick in the same place, but basically you're trying to keep that fulcrum just as you would when you play in the same spot. So. That's the way you can sort of roll with that, right? I see guys kind of go to their shoulder, go to their legs. It's a pretty cool little trick and really pretty simple to get going once you kind of understand how that works. The other thing I want to show you guys is a little stick flip thing. And this one is this guy. Okay. And this one, when I teach this to a lot of people, they think that they're actually throwing the stick, and that's not the case in this. All we're doing is hitting the drum and at the moment of impact, releasing the stick, so it rotates. So the height and the speed of the rotation are all determined on how hard you hit the drum. Okay, so I'm gonna hit, hold French grip, right at the moment of impact, let the stick flip out, so. Okay, and I am lifting my hand up just to go so the stick's gonna clear the rim. That's the one thing I'm really focused on, is making sure that the stick doesn't come into the rim this way. Right, you can hit it harder, it'll rotate farther and higher. Right, and you can kind of sky it. You just got to be careful on your release time, because you can sky it or you can impale people in the audience. So that one's not the best thing to do. Left hand, I think, is a little bit easier. It's already set up for you, and you're already sort of raised with the left hand traditional grip. You just open up that fulcrum, and the stick will fly right out of it. Okay, so you can put it into Hertus, something I put in my individual solo, something that's also in this. We just sort of use it in this little jam in a 16th note form, but we can do something like. Okay. So the most important part with that is realizing that you're not actually flipping the stick, right? You're not doing that. You're literally letting the stick bounce off the head and flip that way. So those are, I would just call it a little bounce flip, and then stick on stick. So hope you guys have fun with those. There's a bunch of YouTube videos out. I've done a couple lessons on the Vic First site with both of those guys, so kind of check that out. And on that note, I'm gonna hand it over to Ralph, but I wanna say thanks a lot to my companies, Yamaha Percussion, Evans Drumheads, Vic Firth Sticks and Mallets, and Zildjian Cymbals. Thank you guys very much for coming.